Hello everyone, and welcome once again to Let's Play Skyrim. Last time I left off having just cleared Bloodlit Throne. We're going to explore some of the mountain range, track down some ore veins, clear some passages, and ultimately find our way to another one of those little tiny predator den caves, this one called Greywater Grotto. So you can just work your way out of Bloodlit Throne through this narrow passage, and you'll find your way to an actual paved road. Remains lousy with snowberries, which no one should complain about. But, eventually we are going to intersect an actual paved road. Now, when we do, we can go right or left. I'm going to go right first. This pillar on the left marks the way up to a dragon mound, which we'll explore in a few moments. I'm going to continue this way for now, all the way to the very end. That cave up ahead is not my destination. Not yet, anyway. It's a place called South Fringe Sanctum, which is a quest target for us. It's where Runeal's journal is. It also has its own set-in dungeon quest when we get there, but like I said, that's later. We're just clearing the road for now, mapping things out, so you can see where a path branches off of the road to the left. That's actually the way to South Fringe. We'll keep going up the road. Where we find what I can only assume is the actual road to Cyrodiil that we were riding in on the cart at the very beginning of the game. That's the only place this could really be going. And this gate's actually closed. There are three moonstone veins to track down up here. First one's easy, it's right here by the gate. And the others aren't too hard to find either. We just sneak up a little ways and around to this rock. Right around here, nestled snugly on the inside, there are going to be two more. There's one. And there's two. Now we can head back down to the main road however we please. I'm just gonna go straight there and cut up to the dragon mound. Right where I pointed out those pillars to you. Elk here, cool, don't really care. Let's just head up here, find the mound. More importantly, past it, we should be able to find, off to the right, an orichalcum vein. Somewhere around here. Looks like it should be right around here. If the map is accurate, which it usually is. Oh, I went too far. There it is. That's it for here. Although you may notice a path of sorts continues straight down here. Go just far enough to show you it actually links up with the main road pretty nicely. Right by this iron vein. Let's head back this way just so I can have the peace of mind of having the main road actually cleared. Boy, it's easy to get lost in the snow in the video game. You can see how it happens to people in real life. Here we go. Right back where the path to Bloodlit Throne intersected the road. Oh, but I see a wolf, which means once we're technically in combat, I can cast Bound Sword all I want to. ...64 conjuration. And that's that, which is fine. Now if we turn left, we can just follow the road. Don't want to miss these snowberries though. Alright. Well, pretty soon, we're going to pass by that same iron vein again. There it is. So we've linked back up, and as we head north and downhill, the snow is going to end, first of all, at least on the road. There it is. And shortly after that, the road is going to split. Right up here. Now, straight ahead is Fort Newgrad, where we'll head to soon enough. Keep this intersection in mind. We're going to turn left here and head this way. Now, Greywater Grotto is that cave right there. We'll be going there soon, but I want to show you how this path links up to Helgen, the very start of the game. Talk about coming full circle, am I right? So, that cairn marks the path off to Greywater Grotto. Let's stay on the main road for now. There's really almost nothing to it now. We link up here. This leads up to Fort Newgrad. We'll close that loop soon. And if we head down here, can already see the gate to Helgen. I just need to clear this tiny little stretch of road until we actually get back to familiar territory. Which would be here, the other fork out of Helgen, up toward Fall Creek Stormcloak Camp, Orphan Rock, and Hamar's Shame. So, doesn't get much more full circle than that, if you ask me. Let's head over to Greywater Grotto. It's easy enough to get to. Just follow this little path. And before you know it, we do have ice wraiths. So we'll let everybody deal with those. There's 65 conjuration. Sixty-seven. I'm actually not even sure where Raya is. Seems like she should be helping Barbas out, though. And that's a whole magic of R. That's fine. There she is. 68 conjuration. 'Why she's not helping Barbas, I don't know. He'll do alright on his own. As long as I have marked for death on the thing. Good. Everybody good? Looks that way. Two more ranks of conjuration. And we've got Greywater Grotto on the map. Let me take it off my discoverable locations list. We do need to work our way above the entrance for one iron ore vein. There may be an actual walking path that gets us up here too. I'm not sure. First I need to find the vein. I know it's here above the entrance. There it is. And we can head inside. I think there actually is a good footpath here. There is. Alright, in we go. This is a simple little predator den. We aren't going to run into much. I bet we get conjuration where it needs to be. In fairly short order, which will be good. A solid exploration. That's worth a hard save to me. About 15 minutes in.
Get ready. Trouble ahead.
Yeah, no kidding. I think after this we're gonna wind up doing a spot of smithing.
Watch it.
Find that ore vein and head up here. You can actually see a snow bear fighting an ice wraith already. Go down to this level first. Oh, it's a snowy saber cat, first of all. There's 69 conjuration. And there's 70. Alright, that I'm good through level 52. Level 53, I need one-handed at 30. I'm there already. Level 54, we need smithing at 100. So that's next. Let's just clear this place out then. Utility stuff back on. Punch a snowy saber cat. He drops the last saber cat tooth I need. Those are finally off the list. I can hardly believe it. Over here we got an ice wolf. Another ice wraith. And yet another snowy saber cat. That's the first saber cat tooth that I can learn an effect from. And the first effect is restore stamina. Very good. Three to go. Oh, and look, there's the little chime telling us that Greywater Grotto is cleared. Nicely done. I think I already searched the bandit. We do have an ore vein to mine out. This one is gold. There's a coin purse on the ground, along with a dwarven bow. Unlocked chest, with nothing that great inside. And somewhere down here is where the ice wraith died. There it is. Awesome. Okay. And that's it. So, let's make a pit stop at the guardian stones. Throw on the warrior stone since we're gonna do the last 25 ranks of smithing. And we'll head to Lakeview Manor for a smithing interlude. Anyway, yeah, that's Greywater Grotto. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. There's another bandit that I almost missed. Didn't realize he was hiding in there. Alright, first we need to hit the Guardian Stones. Let's throw on the warrior. Now let's head to Lakeview Manor. It's time to get smithing to 100. We'll offload our other goodies first, of course. Not that we have that many. Check check the garden, which has respawned. Let's harvest all the top shelf ingredients. Let's put that last saber cat tooth in here. Am I carrying anything else that needs to go in there? Yes. Two glass. And two straw. That's about all that's left that would go in there, but still. Very good. Once we're inside, drop off all our ingredients. Drop off soul gems. I thought I had some. I guess not. Good, we'll check the girl's chest. It's empty. Check with our spouse.
Nice. The gold is flowing nicely. Here's your half of the profits, my dear.
Hmm.
I'll be here if you need me, love.
I guess that's it. Now that the distance is so much less, I figure I can just carry everything with me and it's not a big deal, so let's do our little bit of smelting. Then we can just grab out everything and get to work. Start with jewelry, that's fastest. Seventy-six, 77, 78, 79, 80. And that gets us to level 49, so we'll take a little break to level up. 49 is a health level, and we are going to take Muffled Movement from the Sneak Tree. Noise from armor is reduced 50%. Not bad. With that, we'll get back to it. We'll do jewelry first. I think I was doing silver jeweled necklaces. Yes. Then I think silver ruby ring. Alright. Let's try. Ooh. Let's try arrows next. Those are easy. Glass is best. There's 81. Then I'll do Elven. Smithing's at 82. That's awesome. Now I'm just going to do leather bracers. Start with what I already have. I need to tan all my pelts in the leather. That will take a while. Maybe I'll start with just my wolf pelts. Save myself a little time. Thank you. And of course, we're gonna need leather strips too, before long. Alright. Yeah, we're gonna need a hell of a lot more than that. I should just do all the wolf pelts. Well, let's do everything. Good grief. I've collected a lot of animal hides already. Good grief. It'll be worth it though. A little tedium now means I can just rip through all the leather bracers, and honestly I've got more than enough leather to get smithing all the way to 100 without doing anything else. Which is good. Why we were so diligent about collecting it the whole game. Alright. I'll start with 100 and change and see where that gets me. I've got 1,500 strips, right? If I do 300, that's 1,200 and 1,200. Another 100 is 1,100 and 1,600. Another 100 is 1,000 and 2,000. That's actually what I should do. More or less, but I'll go in increments of 100, just to keep myself a little more sane. 83 smithing, 84 smithing, 85 smithing, 86 smithing, 87 smithing, 88 smithing, 89 smithing, 90 smithing. Fun fact, we're now as good as Yorland Greymane, at least according to the creation kit. '91 smithing. Alright, need more strips. No real surprise there. What do I got? Alright, let's drop it down to 1,000. It's just a nice even number. Alright, we're doing well. Awesome. Let's do some more. 92. 93, 94, 95. And I will take a break to level up. Level 50 is a stamina level. Achievement unlocked. Master. Reach level 50. 34 out of 75 achievements. 45%. So close is still Gatekeeper. At level 50, I want to take Necromage out of the Restoration Tree, which is all spells are more effective against undead. So there we go. Six. 97. 98. Almost to 99. And we need to tan more strips. I'm just going to drop to 700. I think that'll be enough to finish it. Nine 100. Booyakasha. All right, let's drop all our stuff off again. Don't screw with me, game. Come on now. Oops, I want that orichalcumore. All those leather bracers, we can just go drop upstairs. Now, what do I need next? I need sneak at 40. I should get out in the world and sneak. And try for sneak attacks. Interesting. I love it when the engine glitches. Must be an Argonian thing. There we go. All those leather bracers. All the jewelry I made. Can go in here. I think that's it. I think we're good otherwise. Yeah, so let's head back out. Only now, I want to sneak. Jesus, Barbas, move. Thank you. Shouldn't be very hard to get sneak to 40. And after that, we're going to boost conjuration 30 more ranks. So, the real question is, do I need to bother with the Guardian Stones? I think so. I think I want to default to having the Mage Stone on. Of all the skills I have left to raise, the magic skills take the longest. We'll switch back to the Mage Stone, and I am going to head back to Greywater Grotto. We've got about 20 minutes left in this video, which is good. We've got a little exploring to do. Our next target is another cave called the Bonechill Passage, which is going to take us to a dragon roost called Ancient's Ascent. From here, we just head this way. We'll be in pretty good shape. You can already see the cave over there, and there's this big flat space between here and Helgen. Shockingly, there's really nothing out here until we get down a little ways to the path. And this path closes another nice little loop that I'll show you when I get down there. Not quite there yet, I still have a little farther to go. So Bonechill's up there, past that archway. Here's the path I'm talking about. Nothing's working. There. We'll shred that bear. Head down here, and what I'm really trying to show you is, before I even explore this little cavern, note the waterfall over here. You can track along there, down this little creek, and looks like we got a dragonfly by, which I'm fine with. Should notice a familiar bandit camp and pond. That's where the white stag spawned. Up there is Ancestor Glade. In other words, familiar territory. I specifically pointed out the top of that waterfall. Or that waterfall, because I knew we'd be here at the top. Looks like these poor people got torched by a dragon. And in fact, if we investigate the cabin, there's evidence to bear that out. Under the bed is a copy of Purloined Shadows, pickpocket skill book we've already read. And here is a note to the authorities, which we can read and take off our book list. Note to the authorities. I have heard talk about the dragons, but didn't believe it until now. One flew by last week, and ever since we have seen him fly back and forth from a nearby mountain peak. My wife thinks we should move away, go somewhere else. I told her that would be nonsense. As long as we don't bother it, it won't bother us. Still, I thought it would be best if we report it to the local authorities. The creature's lair is just south the hill behind our shack, near Bear's Cave Mill. Well, I think we see that it did end up being quite a serious problem for our friends. So only two ore veins to find between here and Bonechill Passage. There's an iron vein over to the left of this path. It's pretty easy to find. Won't go that fast, but just sneaking everywhere will raise sneak. Get me the one rank I need for the next benchmark. In the meantime, as we follow the path up to Bonechill Passage, right when you see the stairs, there's a silver ore vein off to the right. Less urgent now that smithing is maxed, but still, I think, worth it to find the ore veins.
There's a cave here. Perfect hideout for bandits, or worse.
I as we head up here, we will discover Bonechill Passage. Take it off my discoverable locations list. And head inside. Coin purse right off the bat. You can see an ice wraith there. That's always nice. Where did his ice pile land? That's weird. She killed him, like, right here, but the pile just seems to be MIA. That's fine. Dead bandit. It is weird, though. Here we have a knapsack, a copy of 2920 mid-year, which I think is the heavy armor one, if I remember right. I do know we've already read it, so it doesn't matter that much, but still. Up here, of course, we got Frost Troll. Dead goat with goat horns. That's awesome. With those, I need 32 more. He hasn't seen me yet. That's pretty great. Trying to wait until detection winds down.
God, no.
Not a whole lot going on down under the bridge.
Just a scratch.
There are a couple of searchable skeletons. And a potion. Oh, there it is. Alright, Bonechill Passage is cleared. Good work, Raya. All by your lonesome. So let's take it off the clearable locations list. And now, let's head up and out to Ancient's Ascent, the Dragon Roost. We still aren't anywhere near leveled enough for a revered dragon, so it'll probably be Ancient, which we've demonstrated we are more than capable of handling. Let's just head on out. As I recall, yeah, nothing to worry about up here. Well, besides the obvious, the dragon, of course. Yep, ancient dragon. So there is Ancient's Ascent. I'm going to say that's worth a hard save. We have discovered the location. Now we just need to clear it. The best help I can be, I think, is pretty much always market him for death. She's rocking him. This isn't going to be a problem at all. And he keeps actually landing, which is even cooler. Oh, he's down for good. Awesome. Let's just hide here. What the hell? Come on now. Okay, this is getting absurd. At least I don't have to worry about Barbas getting killed. Alright, let's search the dragon. Wait for the soul to absorb. Oh! There's the lovely chime telling me Ancient's Ascent is cleared. Take it off the list. Make sure it worked right. Sure did. Search the boss chest. Ooh. I don't know about you, but I'm gonna call that an upgrade for my friend Raya.
Here's my thing. Of course, Thane. How can I be of service?
Daedric Sword of Thunderbolts. Definitely beats the Ebony Dagger.
Let's go.
And let's not forget our word of power. Allegiance. Animal allegiance. It's our second one. So let me unlock it. And let me translate the word wall right quick. It says... Well, first I need to take that word off my shout list. Alright, now that one reads, Lacnir Littlehammer raised this stone in memory of his servant, Humble Vakiza, who swore allegiance to the kings of Skyrim and died in Grey Autumn. Well, there you go. Alright. We've backfilled all that, so quickest thing now is to backtrack to Bloodlet Throne. We're going to do South Fringe Sanctum next. Probably in the next video. Just considering the fact that we're nearly at 1 hour. I'm paying better attention this time. I realize the last two ran long. So we'll head over to South Fringe Sanctum. We've already explored most of the area. We just have the side path with the actual cave to check out. Oh, and I thought I was going to get a sneak attack. Was the only reason I did that. I don't normally slaughter bunnies. Not for no reason, anyway. All right. We wander down the trail here. We get on this side path, and believe it or not, it actually splits again. To the right is South Fringe Sanctum. Let's head left first, along this part of the split. Everything runs downhill, but one goes a lot faster than the other. We have two ore veins and a little treasure cache to find, if you're wondering what I'm after. Down here on the right is a silver vein. Down here, overlooking Fort Newgrad, where we'll be heading fairly shortly, is an overlook with a chest. Actually has some good stuff in it. A copy of the Conjuration skill book, The Warrior's Charge, which we've already read. And a skeleton. And now we can go this way to close the loop and get back to South Fringe Sanctum. There is one more ore vein, a silver vein here on the right. Let's quickly nick that. And let's head up here. Right at the 1 hour mark, we have discovered South Fringe Sanctum, which is great. Take it off my discoverable locations list. Bounce up here. I'll somewhere out here there should be a spell sword. There's always one outside. Where did they go, I wonder? Did I just forget to render him? Possible. Yes, there she is. There's your spell sword. I'm just gonna drop down here and see if I can hide long enough to get a little sneak cred. Barbus seems more than capable of handling business on his own, but here we go. Hiding from hostiles. Raises sneak. Better than everything except actually landing sneak attacks. Being successfully hidden from a hostile is clutch. I said, the only thing that's... I'm muffled. Why do I care about movement speed? Oh, it doesn't matter, Barbus bagged her. Right there in the cave mouth, which is going to make it very difficult to search her, but not impossible. I do have telekinesis. There we go. Nothing I need anyway. Alright, good. Okay, cool. So, let's enter the dungeon and end the video because we're at 1 hour. I like it, baby. I like it. All the crafting skills are maxed. At level 54 is when I'm going to take the Dragon Armor perk. And we are finally going to make all of our endgame gear. That'll happen faster than you think, because once Sneak hits 40, my next move is to quickly power Conjuration 30 ranks to 100. There are at least a couple levels in there. Then, maybe I'll go Master Speech, so I never have to worry about it. Anyway, we're getting very close. Next time, we'll clear South Fringe Sanctum and hopefully get that one rank of Sneak we need. Until then, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoy my videos, please consider clicking on an ad, liking, sharing, or subscribing. It really helps me out. But know that even if you don't, I truly appreciate the time you spend watching, and hope you have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.